Hey, my name is Eric Worrell, and in this video, we're going to be doing a review of Mackeeper. So if you're familiar with Mackeeper and you've been researching it, you've probably got an issue with your Mac where maybe it's slow or it's taking a long time to load or websites aren't loading. And you're thinking, you know, maybe this software can fix that problem for you. So what we're going to do is we're going to run through the tool, if you do pay for it, what it looks like, some of the pros, some of the cons, and why don't we get started right now. So when you do download the tool, this is actually the paid version that you're now seeing on the screen, what you're seeing in the background here. This is just their website. Thought I'd make for a nice little visual in the background. So this is what the tool looks like when you purchase it. I should say at the end of this video, if you're looking to purchase this, I do have a link in the description of this video. It is an affiliate link, but I do appreciate it if you use my link. Same price to you, but I make a small commission and I appreciate the support. So let's go through a little bit of this tool. It starts off pretty basic where you can just do a find and fix and you can start scan. So this scan will go through and it's looking for junk files. It'll look for performance, security, and privacy. So this is a pretty typical tool right here. If you're looking at other competitors, and at the end of this video, I will have a video that compares this to the Clean My Mac product, which I've also used and done a review video on as well. So while this is working, one thing I wanted to highlight that I do like about this service is they have live customer support 24/7, including a phone number that you can use. So you can see that this scan worked pretty quick, found a few items that they need to fix. But the customer support is actually pretty good on the side here, which I was pretty impressed with, that it wasn't just some kind of automated bot. So why don't we click fix items safely on here. So while that's running, why don't we take a look at some of the items here on the left-hand side. It's doing a safe cleanup, and it's going to move into Duplicates Finder and Smart Uninstaller. For Smart Uninstaller, the reason that this is important is it just cleared 5 megs off my computer. But a lot of times people who are unfamiliar with Macs think that you know, if you have an application, you can just drag that application from the application folder and into the trash, and that will delete it off your computer. But there are still cache files and log files that are still cluttering up your computer, and that's what these type of services like Mackeeper do, is they help to eliminate those files that are kind of hidden on your computer. So as far as the safe cleanup, it cleaned up just 1.42 gigs. If your computer is attacked and the hard drive is full, you're going to see a lot bigger number. But I tend to run these programs pretty frequently on the regular on my computer. If you go to your Apple menu and about this Mac, this is where you can click on storage and just get a snapshot of where your storage is at. If you do this on your computer and your storage is way over here, like I have 500 gigs, but like you get down to that last 5-10% of your storage being available, that's when you're gonna start seeing your computer kind of working a little slow. So just running these simple find and fix and safe cleanups will help remove some of that. And then why don't we go to Duplicates Finder, 0 files removed. And then Smart Uninstaller, which we mentioned earlier, 5 megs were cleared. And again, I just ran this a week ago, so your numbers are gonna be much, much higher. Let's take a look at Memory Cleaner over here and see how this looks. So we're gonna open this up, and it's saying that available memory is about 8 gigs, occupied is about 8 as well. So this is saying that for my RAM, that 8 gigs are occupied and 8 gigs are available. Now, I'm not a computer guru, and I'm sure somebody will correct me in the comments, but basically what it is RAM is your working memory, your storage, your hard drive is just your storage memory. So when you add a new application to your computer and it says this is gonna take up 200 megabytes of space, that's gonna go space on your storage. But when you actually start running that program, that's gonna start using up available memory. So the more programs you have running, Chrome, if you use Google Chrome, is a pretty big violator of this, uses a lot of RAM. So what I'll do right now, we'll see if we can actually see this happen in the background. I'm gonna close out of Chrome right now. I'm gonna see if this has an effect. You can see that it instantly just jumped up to available memory because I'm no longer using an internet browser in the background. And right now I have another program open. This is called Zoom, which you can use to record videos. I'm going to close Zoom out. And you might see just a little bit of a jump. And again, kind of just jumped up right there. So why don't we clean memory and see how this looks? So I'm gonna let that run in the background, and why don't we take a look at update tracker while that's running in the background. So this is saying 6 updates have been installed automatically. This is just your app store. So if you have different apps that you've purchased over the years and some of them, you know, aren't updated the same way an iPhone's gonna work and you get all those iPhone updates, this will automatically update those for you. So let's go back to Memory Cleaner. Now you can see that available memory is at 11 gigs. So that's great. We just cleared out a couple right there, a couple gigs. So here you can kind of just see an overview. 2 gigs were cleaned up and then occupied memory is accounting for 5 gigs right now. And then available memory is about 10 gigs. So that's much better right away just from doing the Memory Cleaner. And then apps and processes. This is the most resource consuming processes. I tend to stay away from things like kernel underscore tasks because I don't know what those things are. But this is something where, like, you know, I can look at this and say, all right, Garmin Express services, that I have a Garmin for my bike and I don't use that in the winter. So why don't I just close that out? Are you sure you want to quit this process? Quit it. And you can just kind of go through and see if there's anything like that that's causing you issues. Your Finder, all that is your Finder is open, right? You can see Finder. That's how you can always tell if something's open. But again, if you just close it right here, that doesn't actually close out your Finder. Your Finder's still open. So if I click this, quit Finder. All right, and just like that, we're kind of clearing up processes on here. So one of the issues that I have is I'll do video work and video can be pretty taxing. And if I'm doing a live stream on Facebook, I noticed that right here, it still has the Garmin Express open. So I'm gonna try quitting that again, see what happens with that. But if you're gonna do something that requires a lot of working memory on your computer, you can go into this program and start closing out different things that you think might be taking up a lot of memory right now. So we covered Memory Cleaner, Update Tracker, which is pretty simple, login items. So the login items, what this does is you can kind of go through and see if there's any items that are opening up automatically on login and make sure that they're not doing that. So as you can see, I wasn't sure what this was and I chatted with a support professional here and I said, can you explain login items to me? And they said, with login items, you can take control of how fast your Mac boots up by controlling which applications launch every time you start it. So I never use iTunes, but it always logs in. So this is a pretty easy one. ScreenFlow, which I'm using to record this video. It's a tool just for doing ScreenFlow, or excuse me, screen recordings. I will put a link to that too if you're interested in it, but I don't want these two programs booting up automatically when I launch my computer because it's taking more memory of my computer to launch and it's gonna take longer to launch my computer. So I'm gonna remove these two selected items and now they have been removed from the startup list. So why don't I do a little quick rescan and now you can see they're not there. That's why I use a program like this to make sure that my Mac is running its best, because I'm not somebody who's gonna go into the back end of my computer and try to figure things out. So why don't we take a look at internet security. Protect what matters most, your privacy and your personal data. All right, so antivirus. Mackeeper's built-in antivirus protection uses top-grade security tools and provides regular database updates. So I'm gonna start a scan. Well, while that's running, why don't we go into another portion of this, which is called Track My Mac. So you get one device that is covered by this and you can download Track My Mac for your mobile device. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you on the screen how I'm gonna set that up by doing a screen capture of my phone as well. So you can see that there are really good reviews. There's a 4.5 star rating on this Track My Mac, and this is what's going to connect with your Mac. So what this will do is if somebody were to steal your Macintosh, your laptop, you'll be able to track it with this app, but also snap a photo when they open it up. So that's a pretty cool feature. So while my phone is adding this app, why don't we go back to internet security? You can see that this is still running a scan right here. So we're gonna continue to let that run. And then why don't we go back to Track My Mac and on the app on my phone. So I'm gonna pull this up on the screen, which just kind of shows you the main elements here that we're looking at. So we're talking about anti-theft instant reporting, so you can get an exact location along with the photo of the suspect, and parental control, which you can limit screen time of your kid, lock and unlock your Mac with one tap. So same thing that you're seeing on the iPhone screen right now. So we're gonna click get started, and you'll have to create an account. All right, so now I have set up the app, and you can see that it is showing my MacBook Pro, but it says that it's not paired. So I'm just gonna click on the paired button and it's zooming in. So now you can have a rough idea of where I live. So now what we can see here is you can report it stolen, and this is register your phone number to be notified over the phone in the event of a new anti-theft report generation. You can enter your phone number and then you can report it as stolen. That's where you can take pictures of somebody if they open up the MacBook. You can track it on here to see where it is, and then you can also lock your screen and view reports. So pretty cool feature. I'm not gonna get too deep into the weeds on it. You can check it out if that's something you're interested in, but I just wanted to make that a point of this review video. So going back, let's take a look at internet security. Still zero items found, still kind of loading there. And why don't we check out some new privacy features here while that's still scanning the computer. So secure your internet connection. Enjoy the freedom to surf safely without worrying about being hacked or tracked. One click is all it takes. So this is a VPN private connect, one click online privacy. So we'll click next. Protect your private info. Tired of ISPs and advertisers knowing your browsing history? VPN private connect makes your address and sends your traffic through servers around the world. I'm feeling like I'm gonna probably get sold something here, but we'll see. And they hide from hackers. So, you know, they're selling the product here. So open. Be careful you're not using a private connect. All right, secure your internet connection, protect your private info, stop hackers, okay. And I'm gonna put best server turn on. While this is running here, I'll go back to internet security, see where we're at. Still zero items found, kind of closing in on the end. So we got a few programs running on here right now. We're setting up a VPN to make sure that we have a secure internet connection. And then I don't want to overtax this, but we'll take a look at anti-tracking. Stop advertisers from spying on you. Next, browse faster without trackers bogging down your system. You'll enjoy a noticeable speed boost. And then stay hidden online with your browsing data masked. Your privacy is protected. Okay, sounds pretty interesting. All right, you can see that you are now using a private connect. So the VPN is turned on and we are not gonna be tracked. We're gonna secure the internet connection, protect your private info, and stop hackers in their tracks. So that's a really cool feature. This is probably where you're gonna see why the Mackeeper comes with a monthly fee as opposed to a one-time purchase fee. That's definitely something you should be aware of, that if you are using Mackeeper, it's an ongoing fee. And you can see up in the top here that it added a little VPN notice here over top of the Mackeeper logo. So this is where you can kind of see what's going on right now, that we did a safe cleanup, the antivirus is still working, and then the VPN private connect is on. So we're on the best server is what we're connected to with the VPN. So that's a pretty cool feature. Why don't we go over to anti-tracking and run this. We're gonna open, it says anti-tracking is not installed, so stay hidden online. Safari extension coming soon, Chrome extension coming soon, Firefox extension coming soon. So it looks like this is something that is going to be launching in the near future that you can add as an extension onto your browser. If you're not familiar, what an extension is it's these little items up here. So you can add extensions to your browsing experience. And a lot of these like that I'll use, and this is a good example, like you can use this one's called Screenshot. I can capture a visible part of the page and then I can kind of mark it up and be able to download that image. And that one's called Awesome Screenshot. So what it's saying is that there's going to be a Chrome extension for anti-tracking. So looks like this is still a pretty new service and is gonna be coming out in the near future. All right, going back to antivirus, zero items found on my Mac, so that's good. And last but not least, we have the Adware Cleaner, and this, there was also zero items deleted, so it's good to know that that is taken care of. So for the last part of this video, I wanna talk about the pricing. So you can see, and this may be different by the time you take a look at it, but there are different plans, most popular, premium, standard, basic, and then these are typical in that if you pay annually, you can save money on that. Just know that Mackeeper is a monthly service, right? So that's why you're gonna be paying per month. But the reason for that is you are going to get the additional coverages where you have that private VPN, you have the Track My Mac features that this has. If you're looking for a product that is a one-time fee, check out the video on the screen right now. That is a review of Clean My Mac X. And if you want the premium service with premium support, I would definitely suggest Mackeeper. All right, thanks for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you found this helpful. And again, you can use my link in the description and pinned comment below. I appreciate your support. All right, take care.